Drop Kings, baby. Marco Rojas kwam vorige zomer over van het Australische Melbourne Victory. Hij kwam na twee eerdere Europese avonturen in Duitsland en Zwitserland uit bij SC Heerenveen. Afgelopen weekend tegen NAC Breda had Heerenveen een complete off day. De 26-jarige vleugelspeler kijkt daarom het liefst alweer vooruit richting de wedstrijd van aankomend weekend tegen Feyenoord.
We have to learn from the last game and make sure that we turn up on Sunday at 100% because now we need to win. We need the points and we desperately want to achieve the playoffs. So I think that this week we will work very hard and then I'm pretty sure we will turn up on Sunday.
And the game is here at home. Does that help?
Definitely. I think you could see that their game for them being at home really helped them too. So it does help when you're playing at home. It'll be a difficult game against a very good team. But we know what we need to do to make the playoffs, and it's been something we've been working towards the whole season. So we want to make sure that we're 100% ready.
De Nieuw-Zeelander met Chileense roots kende een iets wat stroeve start in Friesland, maar mocht de afgelopen drie wedstrijden starten in de basis en scoorde tweemaal tegen ADO Den Haag.
Yeah, it's a great feeling. It's good to be on the pitch. It's good to be able to help the team, to be part of the first 11. It's been a long time coming. But I'm glad to be out there and to get the two goals last week as well was really nice.
Was that also your best match this season?
I'm not too sure. I watched it back and it was okay, but I think obviously when you have the end product, then it all seems pretty good and well. But I think there have been games where maybe the rest of my play has been better, but I haven't been able to finish it off in the last in the box or anything like that. So I don't know. I'm still undecided if it was my best game.
Dit ziet er dreigend uit. Sterker nog, daar is de goal voor Heerenveen. Rojas met het doelpunt.
Rojas is dus geboren en getogen in Nieuw-Zeeland. 18.000 kilometer hier vandaan, precies op de andere kant van de wereld. Ondanks dat Rojas eerder heeft gevoetbald in Europa, moest hij eerst wel weer even wennen.
The culture and everything is a lot different too. It's been difficult to adjust to because I'm so far away from home. But as a footballer, this is where I wanted to be. So sometimes you have to sacrifice a few things, and I realize that there have been times where it's been very difficult when I haven't been playing or we haven't been playing great, and then you're by yourself and that can be tough. But I speak to family and friends as much as possible, try and keep in contact with them as much as I can. Like I said, I've just kind of been fighting through, trying to turn it around. And I'm happy that I've managed to do that the last few weeks, and hoping that can continue for the last few games.
Also, there's a big time difference. Can your family see you playing? Or?
Yeah, they can, but the hours that they need to stay awake or they need to get up aren't great. For example, the last game, they watched, they streamed it online, but they would have had to be up or stay up till 12:30, I think. And then you have the games on Saturday evening where it's maybe 3:30 in the morning. The best games for them are the nighttime ones, which are about 6 o'clock. So the time difference does make it a bit difficult.
They do get up then at 3:30?
Yeah, they get up, especially because Dad's always watched as many games as he could. He loves watching football. He loves watching me playing, and Mum too. They're pretty proud parents. They've always managed to do whatever they could to watch the games that I play.
your most dedicated fans, I think.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
In Heerenveen heeft Marco dus even tijd nodig gehad om naam te maken. Maar in Nieuw-Zeeland is hij zeker geen onbekende. De aanvaller speelt al sinds 2011 in het nationale team en heeft inmiddels al 40 interlands op zijn naam staan.
I mean, I love playing for my national team. It's an honor to play for your country. It was a lot of traveling, especially towards the end of last year. We traveled to Japan. We played Japan in one window. We traveled home. We had a qualifier at home. I think it was October or maybe September. And then in November we traveled back to New Zealand to play Peru and then traveled to Peru to play in the second leg. So it was a lot of traveling. I've done it a few times, so you know how to deal with it. You know what you need to do to recover and all of those kind of things. But it's still definitely difficult to travel that much.
Rogas, fraaie actie van de vleugelaanvaller uit Nieuw-Zeeland.
Do you like the life here in Friesland?
Yeah, I do. I mean, it's a little bit different to where I was before, to Melbourne. Smaller place, but it's a nice place to live. It's a friendly environment. The people have been good to me here. They've done everything they can to make sure that I'm comfortable and that I'm living comfortably. And it's a very good club as well. So they kind of work together and it creates an environment that I'm happy to be in. There's quite a few foreigners, a few Scandinavian boys, and obviously Nemanja, who came in at the same time that I did, who I tend to hang out with a little bit more. But everyone's pretty good. Like I said, if you need anything or you need help with something, there's always someone here you can talk to, and they'll all try and help you as much as they can.
Yeah, now this season is running to the end. How do you see next season?
I think next season is a season where I'll need to pick it up quite a lot. It's been a very up and down this first season, and I think the second season will be a good year for me to push on and to really start doing well and really start playing more and etc. And it's a season I really look forward to, but first of all there's these last few games that we need to play, and then there's the break, so I just have to focus on that. But I'm hoping that the next season will be a big one for me.